So, hello. Wow, this looks amazing, amazing, amazing. Hello up there, hello. Great. Right, so I'm interested in the psychology of dance. And I want to know things like, you know, why do we dance? What's the point of us dancing? And I want to know things like, how do we communicate through dance? How do we communicate different things through our body movement? And in the past, I've spoken about studies where we look at the relationship between your hormones and the way you get funky on a dance floor. We're not doing that today, I'm afraid. But what we are going to do, can we start by all just clearing our laps? Clearing our laps. Marvellous. And can you just shake your hands out? Just shake your hands out. Oh, lovely. Get those shoulders moving. Okay, lovely. You can stop now. You can stop that. Okay, well, I want to find out what happens is I'm going to play some music, and this is all about the psychology of the groove. And I want to know how groovy you are. And I want you to kind of feel this piece of music. We're going to have some music playing, and I want you to kind of dance in your mind and just see what happens with your body, if anything happens at all. Just sitting where you are, and let's just see what happens. That's the first piece of music, please. A bit louder. Marvellous. Okay, just think, listen to it. Is anyone... Okay, thank you very much. That's the end of the music. So did anyone feel that? Yes. Marvellous. This time, please stand up. Stand up, stand up, stand up. Marvellous is great. And this time, now there we were thinking about how you kind of might think about music in the body. This time I want you to kind of move your body a bit more to the music. Let's have the music, please. Let's have the music now. Nice and loud. Okay. Thinking about this piece of music. We've got a groover up there in the front. Fantastic. Okay, just let your body go. Just let that... Just let that go. Oh, just let that feel good. Oh, thank you very much. Kill me. You sit down. You sit down. You sit down. Jolly good. Right, so... The eye... So, now why am I interested in this? Well, of course, the reason I'm really interested in it is to try and understand the function of dancing. I want to know why do we dance and what point is there to dancing? Now, of course, in the lab, we look at all kinds of functions of dancing. And one of the big things we're interested in looking at is the relationship between dance and Parkinson's disease. So, we know that Parkinson's disease is a neurodegenerative disorder, and it affects all kinds of aspects to do with balance and walking. It can impact on people's mood. It can make them feel depressed and more anxious. I have some water while I'm... And what we know about these people is that most of them take some kind of medication to try and relieve some of the symptoms. I like dry mouth. Come on. Right, over here, just in case. So, we have Parkinson's patients who have these various symptoms. And what was found coming out of America a few years ago was that when these people with Parkinson's engaged in recreational dance, some of their symptoms reduced. So there were half a dozen studies published showing that when people danced, their balance improved or their walking improved. And there were all kinds of medical improvements in these people. So what we did at the University of Hertfordshire was to start a study looking at what happens psychologically to people with Parkinson's disease when they start to dance. Now, of course, there are other studies in the UK too happening here. Our study was particularly interested in looking at the physical issues, the cognitive issues, and the emotional issues for people with Parkinson's disease. So we've so far run two studies. And in both studies, what we've done, we've got patients, we've assessed them for a couple of hours each on physical conditions. And then we've put them through about a dozen dance classes of different styles. One dance style was using contact improvisation, which is very kind of weird and kind of something you see on the stage here a lot, probably. people kind of, you know, being quite abstract, off the music, rolling around. And the second study we did, we looked at kind of party dancing. So we did things like cheerleading. We had everyone doing with pom-poms on the beat. We gave people Bollywood dancing to do, a whole range of different dance styles. The critical thing was in study one, we asked people to dance off the beat. There was no metric beat or anything to work with. In the second study, they were really working on the beat all the time. So for 10 weeks, they were just dancing on the beat. And then we looked at changes in all kinds of areas of their lives. And one of the major things we found was that there were big changes in their physical ability, so their balance and their walking, which confirmed other people's studies. We also found an improvement in their quality of life, which was quite amazing. So their physical discomfort scores went down. And we also found the big changes in their mood. So we found that their anxiety levels were reduced and their vigor levels went up. Now, of course, these are really important things for people with Parkinson's disease, because there are all kinds of aspects of the condition where anxiety might be a large problem. Now, there were all kinds of other findings too, which I don't have time to tell you about. But one of the questions I was left with was, well, why are we having these benefits? What is it about dancing which is helping these different types of people? Is it just the case that it makes their body feel good? It loosens them up in a kind of muscular way or a joint way, and that's what helps them sleep maybe? Or is something actually happening in the brain? Because we know that Parkinson's disease is a neurodegenerative disorder. It comes from a certain part of the brain. So, now of course, it's very hard, of course, for us to kind of look at the brain while people are dancing. But what we've done a big lot of search of the literature, and what we found is that there are three elements in dancing which are vital to improving health. And these three elements can sometimes distinguish dance from other forms of exercise. Now, the three elements are, one, it's social. There's a lot of social interaction in dance. Two, it's very physical. And three, it's cognitive. It's a kind of learning problem-solving thing. And what we know for each of those three things, there's quite a lot of research which shows that when you engage in those things, you have changes to your brain. The first study, published study, found that those people who are more socially engaged, engaged in the kind of way that you are when you're dancing, were less likely to get dementia 5 years later. There's a relationship between social engagement and the onset of dementia. A study of 5,000 people in America followed up 3 to 5 years later and found that link. So let's have a practice at some social engagement in dance. So we'll stand up. Right. So now we've got some helpers. We've got Rebecca down in Brighton, and we've got Sabine up in Edinburgh, so they can come up as well in their regions. What we're going to do, starting off with your right hand, just follow me. I want you to do this. It goes like that, one, and two. Other side, we go three and four. Now, being very social, I want you to boogie and boogie, but look at the person next to you. Ooh, hello. The person that side. Okay, let's practice that bit again. So it goes one, two, three, four, we boogie, five, six, and seven, eight. The next bit, right arm up in the air like this, and we clap, boom, like that. Oh, well, and then come back again there, and go there again. Now we click twice here, click, 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 click. Now do it again the other side. We go one, two, three, four, and click, and click. Now here it gets difficult. Just watch me now. I want you to do this. Whoa, da-da-dum. And the other way, the other way. But I want to do it like a Mexican wave, starting on this side of the theatre and all there, and going right the way across through the three tiers. So everyone's down here, you ready? And we're going to follow the person on our right. So here we go, and over the top. Brilliant, and bring it back again. Get faster than that, faster, faster, faster. Come on, faster than that. Well done up top there. Right, so let's do that all together. Shall we go? Here we go. So it goes five, six, seven, eight. We go one, two, three, we're gonna boogie to each other. It goes one, two, three, four, we click and click. It goes one, ba, two, ba, and click. Over the top, we go one, two, three, four, and a la dum, bum, 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 bum. Brilliant, brilliant, brilliant. So you can sit down now. So, well, that's right. Sit down, sit down, sit down. Okay, the next bit, physical activity is absolutely vital. There's a part in the brain called the hippocampus. And the hippocampus is thought to be responsible for some of our short-term memories. When you get into middle age, sometimes your memories can start, you can start losing your memories, just ever so slightly. It's thought that the hippocampus shrinks by about 1% to 2% every year, and our memory gets worse and worse and worse and worse and worse. There's a great study, took 120 people, 60 of them had to do physical exercise of the sort like they were dancing three times a week for a year. The other group had to just stretch. The stretching group, their hippocampuses carried on shrinking across the year. The physical exercise group, their hippocampus actually grew by 1% to 2% over the year, measured by fMRI, which is which is incredible. And what they seem to be suggesting is that physical exercise might be good for structures like the hippocampus, which might help people's memory and help them retain their memory. So let's do some physical exercise now. So stand up, please. Stand up. Here's a physical exercise. Starting with your right foot, we're going to march forward. You can't really march very far forward, but we're going to just going to march for three steps. It goes one, two, three, clap. And then we go backwards. We go one, two, three, clap. And then forward again. Back and back. Now we're going to go that way. It goes one, two, three, clap. And one, two, three. And again. Or one, two, three. Now this time, well, just watch this. You have to go like this. It goes in a circle. We go one, two, three, clap, and back, two, three, and clap, and one, two. Now, if you don't want to do that, you can just do this. One, six, seven, eight. So here we go. In a circle, five, six, seven, eight. We go one, two, three, clap, and clap, two, three, clap, and one, two. And back, two, three, clap. Right, let's do that together. Let's do it all together. It goes five, six, march forward. It goes one, two, three, and clap, and down the back. Two, three, clap, and one, two, three, and back. Now we go that way. And again, it goes one. Now with a turn, it goes one, two, three, and around. Two, and one, two, three, and two. Right, sit down, all so exciting. I've got 4 minutes left. The last element is a cognitive element. Some studies have found that when you do cognitive training, you become better at problem solving. And that training can be dancing type training, where you learn, you're using your memory and spatial ability and spatial awareness. And those people who go with mild cognitive impairment, people in my kind of age who are just beginning to forget things, and they go along and do mild training in these memory strategies and problem-solving strategies, they get better at problem-solving, but more areas of the brain light up when they're doing brain and the brain scans, which suggests perhaps that more areas of the brain are supporting particular types of problem-solving. So problem-solving is a very good thing to do, and so let's do some memory work right now. So stand up again, please, stand up. Okay, this time, what you need to do, with your right foot, we need to go to heel forward. It goes a heel and back and heel and back. Over, two, three, four. And then it goes a one, a two, and a three, and a four, and a John Travolta. So on this one, the heel section, the idea here is you need some spatial awareness. Think about which part of the body is working when. We're going to start off with our heels. It goes five, six, seven, eight. It goes one, two, three, four, and ba 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 do ba da ba da ba da ba da. And one, two, three, four, and John Travolta. And again, do it again. And a one, a two, a three, and a four, and a five, and a six, and a seven, and an eight. And a one, two, a three, four, and a five, six, seven, eight. Now stay standing. Because what we know now is, of course, for dance to have health benefits, it needs to have these three elements. It needs to have a social element. It needs to, or doesn't, you know, it's very helpful if it does. It needs to have a physical element to raise your heart rate, and it needs to have a cognitive element so that you're thinking of problem solving. Right, it was, of course, my dream to stand on this stage. If anybody else wants to come and join me on this stage to dance, you're very welcome. So absolutely seriously, we're all going to do that dance all together. Now we'll do all three parts together. We're going to do the social, we're going to do the cognitive, and we're going to do the physical up here on the stage and out there. So if anybody wants to come and join me as we're doing it, please, please do. Everyone's too scared. It's wonderful up here. It's wonderful. Okay, let's have some music then. And we'll do this last one. Now we march forward again. One, two, three. And a breath. Now we go that way.
the cognitive bit. It goes 1, 2, 3, 4. Love. 1, 2, 3. Oh, John Travolta, John Travolta. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1. We're on the top, last time ever.
Si tu la parlami è americano. Quando si fa l'amore sotto la luna.
Over the top.
Come da bene in cave di I love you.
Now wait.
Papa l'americano.
There we go.
That's it. Thank you very much. That's it.